morning, everyone.
I hope you and your families are all safe and well. Today is Friday the 8th of May 2020. 75 years ago today, this country celebrated VE Day, Victory in Europe Day. And to help you get an understanding about VE Day, I've put together this short video.
Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied Expeditionary Force. We may allow ourselves a brief period of rejoicing. But let us not forget for a moment the toils and efforts that lie ahead. Japan, with all her treachery and greed, remains unsubdued. The injuries she has inflicted upon Great Britain, the United States, and other countries, and her detestable cruelties, call for justice and retribution. We must now devote all our strength and resources to the completion of our tasks, both at home and abroad. Advance Britannia! Long live the cause of freedom! God save the King.
Now, it took about 45 seconds from the time the bomb left the airplane until it exploded. And I think there wasn't a man in the airplane that wasn't either timing it with his watch or counting or doing something. I was sure the bomb was a dud. I was sure it wasn't going to work.
After falling for 43 seconds, the time and barometric triggers started the firing mechanism. A uranium bullet fired down a barrel into a uranium target. Together, they started a nuclear chain reaction. Solid matter began to come apart, releasing untold quantities of energy.
Of a better understanding about VE Day, World War II, and the impact that war had on millions of lives, not just in the United Kingdom, but across the world as well. One of the key things was Sir Winston Churchill's speech, where he said, "We may allow ourselves a brief period of rejoicing, but let us not forget for a moment the toils and efforts that lie ahead." Given where we are today, we know that we are all at home at the moment because we can't go outside, we can't be with our friends. But there will be a time when we can again. That's not going to happen quickly. It's going to happen in stages and in parts. And we need to make sure that we're prepared for all the efforts that we've still got ahead for when we will meet again.